You're watching UNICEF television. Since the conflict broke out in Georgia, the capital city Tbilisi has received an influx of more than 128,000 displaced people. Responding to the crisis, UNICEF has delivered vital supplies into Tbilisi. This batch of supplies includes 2,000 family water kits, 1,100 school-in-a-box kits, and other items such as collapsible water tanks and jerry cans. In public school number 51, UNICEF provided beds, linens, blankets, and complimentary food for lactating mothers and babies younger than 2 years old. Dr. Katvang Namsazi is here to support the mothers with breastfeeding. Among them, Lika Nakopia, who just arrived with her six-day-old daughter. In another school that has been converted into a shelter, children play hide and seek as mothers carry on with their daily chores.
I was in the village when the shooting started. It was night. I woke up and heard Mom calling Dad. I thought it was my grandfather doing something in the yard. But in the morning, Mom told me that they had been shooting. Then we went to Gori. The next day, when the shooting started there, my cousin and I ran away and started crying because we were scared.
I was so scared, even more than her. When I was crying, she would comfort me, saying, "Mom, don't cry."
On August 27th, UNICEF Regional Director Maria Kalivis came to Tbilisi to meet with children and their mothers affected by the conflict. Ms. Kalivis listened to their needs and concerns and talked to local media about UNICEF's priority in the emergency response.
These children cry at night, are worried, are more insecure, and keep on asking, when are we going back? And when are we returning? Whatever I sow today, I wouldn't want women and children to stay much longer in those conditions.
In the coming days, UNICEF will focus on providing psychosocial support to the children, as well as getting them back to school as soon as possible. In Tbilisi, Georgia, this is Quinley reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for children.